Hi, my name is Minchul Kim, and I present our paper, Shortest Rectilinear Path Queries to Rectangles in a Rectangular Domain. There are a lot of works for shortest path queries in polygonal domain, like one-point query with fixed source or two arbitrary point query. Most results on one-point query are near linear time, and results on two-point query are near quadratic time, and they assumed that the point query is a point. But different from the point, some obstacular objects are targets in real environment, like chip on the board or buildings in city, and so on. We make the path between power and chip avoiding another chip. Also, sometimes we go to the entrance of building. From this motivation, we consider the problem that obstacles which make the polygonal domain roll sides together. We simply consider the rectangular object and rectilinear path. Note that rectangular domain is made by n axis aligned rectangular obstacles, and the rectilinear path is the path consisting of axis aligned line segments. Rectangle rolls both site and obstacle, so we define two distances from a point P to rectangle R, called minimum distance and maximum distance. Minimum distance, the mean PR, is generally used distance between two objects, while maximum distance, the max PR, is determined by the farthest point on the rectangle from P. With those two distances, we can define four kinds of rectangles according to the location from the point nearest or farthest with minimum or maximum distance. We call them nearest mean, nearest max, farthest mean, farthest max rectangles. For instance, the bottom rectangle is not the farthest from P with minimum distance, but is the farthest with maximum distance. So the bottom rectangle is the farthest max rectangle. That is our result of the paper. We propose the data structure and algorithm to support point-to-rectangle query, which is given a point and a rectangle, report shortest path in O log n plus k with minimum and maximum distance query time in O n square pre-processing time and space. Note that k is the complexity of the reported path. We extend it to segment to rectangle query using O log n factor in pre-processing and space. Also, we can report four kinds of rectangles, nearest mean, nearest max, farthest mean, farthest max rectangles using above results. Our data structure is based on carrier graph of Elgindy and Mitra. They construct carrier graphs, which is direct acyclic for each direction of axis. Using the carrier graph, computing all pair shortest paths takes O n square time and space. From the carrier graph, we construct wakes of each side of rectangles. From now on, we just consider the wake of the left side. Wakes of the other side can be handled similarly. From two endpoints of the left side, we draw two XY monotone paths which go rightwards until they hit rectangles, and then one path from the upper endpoint goes upwards, and one path from the lower endpoint goes downwards. The wake of the left side is the region bounded by those two XY monotone paths. From the point on the left side to any point interior to the wake represented as a gray region, like left figure, there exists the shortest path contained in the wake, and it is X monotone. Our query algorithm is to find four wakes using four horizontal and vertical rays from the query point and handle them separately. If a rectangle is a not incident to the four wakes identified by P, every shortest path from P to any point in the rectangle is XY monotone. Continuously, we just consider when the rectangle is instant to the wake of the left side. First is the minimum distance query between point P and rectangle R. When R is not incident to the wake, the shortest path from P to R is XY monotone, and the minimum distance is determined by a corner of R, so it is done. On the other hand, when R is incident to the wake, the minimum distance is determined by a foot of perpendicular at the left side of R from horizontal sides of another rectangle in the wake. In this picture, by the properties of wakes, there exists the shortest path passing through U or U prime, which are two endpoints of size identified by P. The minimum distances from U to R and from U prime to R are fixed. So using two distances, we can make piecewise linear functions on the size taking the lower envelope. The function is used to decide which shortest path from P to R passing through U or U prime is better. Next is the maximum distance. Likewise, in the minimum distance, when R is not incident to four wakes, the shortest path from P to R is XY monotone, and the minimum distance is determined by a corner of R. Maximum distance is determined by corner of R. When R is incident to the wakes, the point determining the maximum distance lies on the opposite side to P and identified side, like this figure. We know that four distances duv, duv, duv prime, duv prime are fixed, where v and v prime are two endpoints of the opposite side of R. So we use those four distances to handle maximum distance query. We maintain the maximum distance according to the location of P with two simple piecewise linear functions f and g made from four distances. We change of t and maintain the maximum value of the lower envelope of two functions f and g. The range of t is the range of the left side identified by p, so we record the maximum value as the maximum distance to r. As a result, we can obtain the piecewise linear function, which has at most three linear functions as the right figure. The function is used to decide the maximum distance from P to R. For those two queries, we obtain ON scale preprocessing and space to construct carrier graphs and wakes. For given query, identifying wakes takes O log n time using ray shooting structure of Giora and Kaplan, and compute the minimum distance and maximum distance according to the location of P in constant time. Thus, query takes O log n time. Reporting path takes additional time using carrier graph in OK time. Now we report four kinds of rectangles efficiently: nearest mean, nearest max, farthest mean, farthest max rectangles. Finding the nearest mean rectangle is simple. All rectangles do not roll obstacles to find the nearest mean rectangle. So we just make Aaron Voronoi diagram of rectangles without making wakes. Papadopoulou and Lee proposed the algorithm to compute L-infinity Voronoi diagram of segments efficiently, and Aaron Voronoi diagram can be derived from L-infinity Voronoi diagram because two metrics are isometric, so it is done. Next is to find the nearest max rectangle. We first consider the nearest max rectangle is incident to the wake. To find the nearest max rectangle, we compute the lower envelope of pre-computed piecewise linear functions for maximum distance query between point and rectangle. Every piecewise linear function consists of at most three linear pieces whose slopes are minus 1, 0, and 1 in order. Therefore, the lower envelope also consists of at most 3 linear pieces whose slopes are minus 1, 0, 1 in order. So we can compute the lower envelope in linear time to compute 3 pieces with minimum intercept among ON pieces. Now we consider the nearest max rectangle is not incident to the wake. We construct the planar subdivision without using carrier graphs or wakes. We do the point location query and find the nearest max rectangle in the another subdivision. We assume that the maximum distance is determined by the top right corner, and the other cases can be handled similarly. We sort the rectangles in the domain in sum of coordinates of the top right corner. Then we incrementally construct a subdivision of each rectangle in the order. Assume that the subdivision is made by rectangles before R in order. We draw the two XY momentum passes from the left bottom corner of R until they hit the subdivision already made. Then for every point in the red subregion bounded by two XY monotone and the previous subdivision right figure, the maximum distance is determined by the top right corner of R, and it is the nearest max rectangles among all rectangles that maximum distances are determined by the top right corners. Then the subdivision is planar, so total complexity is bounded to the number of rectangles. In the subdivision, we do point location query and find the nearest max rectangle directly. Next is the farthest mean rectangle. Also, we first consider the farthest mean rectangle is incident to the wake. We have ON piecewise linear functions for a side and ON rectangles in the wake of the side. Then we compute their upper envelope in ON log n time. ON piecewise linear functions consist of at most two pieces with slope minus 1 and plus 1, so it requires ON space only. If the farthest mean rectangle is not incident to the wake, the farthest mean rectangle is the one of four fixed rectangles among all rectangles. For each fixed rectangle, we check whether the rectangle is incident to the wake or not, and report one as the farthest mean rectangle. Computing farthest max rectangle is similar to the previous method. When the rectangle is incident to the wake, we handle it similarly in the nearest max query. Instead of computing lower envelope, we compute the upper envelope of piecewise linear functions with maximum distance. When the rectangle is not incident to the wake, the rectangle is the one of four fixed rectangles like farthest mean query. So we can check whether each fixed rectangle is incident to the wake or not, and report one as the farthest max rectangle. Finding the nearest rectangle with minimum distance takes O n log n time and O n space, since in use only around nearest Voronoi diagram. The other three types of queries, we construct carrier graphs and wakes and compute the lower or upper envelope for each side. O log n factor in pre-processing is from the time complexity to compute the envelope. Query time is determined by point location and range shooting query like point to rectangle query. So it takes O log n time with additional path reporting time OK. Moreover, we extend the shortest path queries between line segments and rectangles with minimum distance. For the maximum distance, it can be handled similarly. For given line segment query L instead of point P, we can handle the two endpoints of L similarly as the point to rectangle query. However, we handle interior points of L differently to reduce query time. That problem is reduced to the stepping query and range minimum query problem. There are two and parallel line segments in rectangular domain extending size of rectangles. Each line segment stores the minimum change of x or y coordinate according to the monotonicity. Our first purpose is to report parallel line segments intersected by L efficiently. The stepping query problem can be solved using segment tree. With segment tree, we can obtain all log n nodes in segment tree. For line segments contained in each node, we do the minimum range query using associated Cartesian tree. Then we can obtain the minimum distance from L to R and report the path. For each rectangle, we construct the segment tree and associated Cartesian tree. It takes over n log n time and space. Since the associated Cartesian tree takes the time linear to the number of nodes of the trees, so we make that structure for all rectangles. Total pre-processing time and space are O n square log n. Query time is same as O log n plus k. Stepping query in segment tree takes O log n time, and we obtain O log n nodes. For each node, we do the range minimum query in Cartesian tree. The query time to do range minimum query in Cartesian tree takes constant time, so the total query time takes O log n time with additional reporting path time OK. Our future work is to extend rectangle to rectangle query and computing diameter and center of n rectangles. Also, there is room to reduce the time complexity and space complexity for each query problems. Here are references used in the presentation. And thank you for listening to my presentation.